so far has not been good. It's been shitty, and I feel awkward as I should. This club has got to be the most pretentious thing since I thought you and me.
Hey guys, as you can already tell from the beginning of this video, we're doing something just a little bit different and something that's really cool. Today, I'm out in Michigan with a new friend of mine, Rich Beddoe.
Hey buddy.
Rich, it's so good to see you. It's so good to meet you. Rich and I got in contact on Instagram a little while ago and started talking knives. And we thought it'd be really fun to get together and put together some videos talking about music, talking about knives.
Seth, awesome to meet you. And hi guys, viewers. Obviously, I'm a drummer. I was in a band called Finger 11 for 20-something years, and after that, another band called Santa Sonia. Along the way, I don't know what it is. Something caught my eye about knives. As soon as I found out or looked into Wee Knife, I'm like, man, this is the guy I want to talk to.
Yeah.
I want to get to know this dude, and I want to look at some knives. And so kind of, for me, went from music into knives, and
here we are. Yeah. And by the way, I love your music.
Thanks, man.
I'm excited to share some of it with our page or our audience here.
Cool.
Guys, it's been really cool being in this setting here, listening to Rich, bang away on the kit, playing to some of the songs that kind of brought Finger 11 and you into the limelight.
For sure, yeah. It's cool that you guys got to come down to my little drum room here and, get to play a little bit. It's been an amazing adventure, especially the traveling.
Yeah.
I've been really lucky enough to go around the world a bunch of times. And I don't take it lightly. I get that I'm, a lucky guy. So it's been awesome, man. It's a wild life.
Yeah.
It definitely is.
I'm sure. So you were with Finger 11 when they started.
Yep.
And Finger 11, it was early 2000s?
Yeah, well, so they had Finger 11 had a drummer before me. They were another band in Canada. They had some success in Canada. When we kind of got down here to America, I think it was 1998 I joined the band.
Okay.
And that's when the first record came out. I think I was in the band for 22 years before moving on to Santa Sonia, my next band. Mm-hmm. Like I said, we traveled the world together, the four of those guys. And
had some huge hits as well.
We had some hits, yeah. It's funny to think that, it's, you never know what's going to be a hit,
uh-huh.
You just write songs, you never know which one's going to catch, and, Paralyzer obviously was the big one. Awesome guys, man, I love them, all four of them, and we were really lucky, to do the things that we did. So
I find it fascinating, everybody's a music fan. I don't know anybody that doesn't love music.
Right.
And so just to be able to sit down and talk with you about your experiences on the road, some of the stuff that you've gone through, music, personal life, everything, I just love it. It's so interesting.
Well, I've been really blessed to tour, with, I did Motley Crue's final tour. I know they're coming back now, but got to go over to Europe with Motley Crue, mm-hmm. and Alice Cooper, toured with Ozzy, Kid Rock. I went over there in Europe with him. So, and then in America, a lot of, Nickelback, those guys are really great friends of mine.
I wanted to ask you, why does everybody hate Nickelback?
I've known them back when, we're both from Canada, when they were still kind of playing bars and stuff, mm-hmm. like Finger 11 were back in the day. But I think when any band has the kind of success and radio success that that they do, it's just, I mean, even Pearl Jam have that. Some people hear Pearl Jam. It's like, I've heard that too much on the radio, I don't like it anymore. Or when a band becomes so popular, a lot of people just tend to want to be the person that wants to be the opposite of that. Yeah, Chad's a great, great guy. I saw him not too long ago. They were here in Detroit. And me and my wife ended up on his bus. It's kind of funny. It's 6 in the morning. Those guys were playing Toronto the next day, actually. And because I hadn't seen him in a while, we ended up hanging on the bus. And all their buses left, all their crew left, and their poor security guard and tour manager and bus driver, I think, didn't want to tell Chad, we gotta go. So at about 5 or 6 in the morning, we said our goodbyes and we came on. They're all sitting outside of the bus and tour manager gave me a look so we have a great time. I love those guys. If I gave it,